All right. Back. Wise. Forget these games are always so loud when I start them. What in the world? Sure, why not? Hate all these guys. I don't know how this is gonna go. I don't have very much time tonight to play something. I was gonna play some Vampire Survivors, but I've had this downloaded for the longest time. Okay. Who knows? But with this, we can get into like learning this, play a little bit. I just want to sit back and chill. I guess I could do some power wash simulator.
Welcome to Train Sim World, an immersive and highly detailed rail simulator featuring authentic routes and trains from around the world. This is the training center. Here you can learn about how to navigate and interact with the world, as well as how to operate the many trains. Let's start by looking around. Find each of the markers and look at them.
I'm just looking out. We only know. Oh, I don't want. No, I don't.
Your current objective.
I do not want my controls inverted. That's trash. Put all that in the trash. All right. I think we need sound.
Is shown at the top left of the screen. Walk to the blue marker to complete the current.
Oh, at least we don't walk slow. What? Why do I have a crouch? In what world would I need to crouch in this game?
You've been awarded some action points. These are displayed in the top right corner of the screen and count towards your overall experience level for the game.
Heck yeah. AP, baby.
This is one of the many types of route tasks to be discovered. Keep an eye out for many more types and styles of route tasks, which can involve placing, collecting, or fixing a variety of things. Head into the main building, and you'll continue your induction there. You can pause Train Sim World at any point to review objectives and a lot of other. Now that we've covered some of the basic moving around and interacting with the environment, let's take a walk through the building and find the trains. This is Central Square. From here, you can explore the main training center depot and surrounding yards.
Okay. Can I jump?
Your journey operating trains is just getting started here in the training center. Remember, you can always come. Continue to.
All right. We beat the first training module. Screen elements.
This module will cover the on-screen overlay, known as the heads-up display, or HUD, that is shown when you are in control of a train. Climb up the ladder into the locomotive, and then sit in the seat.
Oh shit, we really doing this, boys.
Welcome to the most important seat in the train.
Conductor's chair.
While sitting here, you'll be in full control. Before you think about moving the train, though, let's look at the HUD overlay that's appeared on the bottom right. The heads-up display is a guide to what your train is doing.
Sitting here.
The main part of the HUD is the speed display. A white bar will appear around the outside to show your current speed, and the red mark indicates your maximum permitted speed.
Let's get this baby cranked up and going!
This is the direction display. An arrow will indicate forward, reverse, neutral directions. This is the power display. A number will indicate what position the power or throttle control is in.
What are you highlighting? Oh.
These are the brake indicators. The exact ones shown will vary by train and will often be visible in the train itself on various gauges. They tell you what's happening in the braking system. The most important one is the BC or brake cylinder. If that's reading zero, then your brakes are released. Anything else, and brakes are applied and you won't be able to move. Every train can have small variations in the HUD unique to the way it works, but they will mostly look the same. As you learn to control new trains, study the HUD and learn how it helps you operate it. If you want to see this again, you can rerun this training module at any time. In this training module, you're going to look at making the train move, and then bringing it to a stop again. While many trains have different controls and are operated in different ways, there are basically always three controls that are common and are required to move the train. The reverser sets the direction between forwards and backwards. The brakes are used to slow or stop the train. The throttle controls how fast the train accelerates. We want to move the train forwards, so move the reverser in that direction. Keep the brake control in release until you can see the brake pipe control needles are reading 5 bar, pointing upwards. This will release the brakes fully. Watch the brake cylinder, or BC gauge, to see it gradually reduce to zero, which tells you that the brakes are now fully released. Apply some throttle to get the train moving. As you apply power, notice the amp bar rising. This is the amount of power being fed into the traction motors. Now that you've reached your target speed, you can move the throttle control back to zero. The train will then coast level ground, and the train will only slow down very gradually.
Oh shit, we got the train moving.
While the specifics of operating brakes vary from train to train, the basic process of stopping is fundamentally the same. Bring this train to a complete stop by holding the brake control in the apply state until you see the brake pipe control needle in the center of your cab desk showing about 4 bar.
Excuse me?
The amount of braking you'll need to apply also varies depending on whether you're going up
uphill, my brake control,
or downhill, and how heavy your train is. Stopping a train is one of the biggest challenges of controlling them, particularly stopping them in the right place. That concludes this module. Restart the module to learn the steps again, or move on to the next module.
No, it's there!
Shh. Don't swing that around, please. That needs to go in the bathroom.
This module will go over the fundamentals of operating junctions to change the path your train will take, and how to navigate using the map. Most rail lines around the world are controlled remotely by a signaling center or dispatcher. From the perspective of the train, the direction taken is automatic. But within yards and depots, many small and frequent movements are required. This makes remote control of the track impractical. In these locations, the direction taken is manually controlled. You can set junctions by either walking up to them and interacting with them, or going to the 2D map and changing them from there. Let's change this junction by hand first. Walk over to it and change it by operating the lever.
I'm going to do it on my map.
Point blades move on the track. Try moving it a few more times until you can see how it works. Let's head over to the train, and then we can look at the map.
No. So this is a train.
Junctions are set correctly. Let's get the train moving and see it all working. If you can't remember how to make the train start and stop, there is a training module you can rerun to remind yourself. Keep the brake control in release until you can see the brake pipe control needle. Watch the brake cylinder, or BC gauge, to see it gradually reduced to zero, which tells you that the brakes are now fully released and you can move the train. Now that you've reached your target speed, you can move the throttle control back to zero. The train will then coast on level ground, and the train will only slow down very gradually. Bring this train to a complete stop by holding the brake control in the apply state until you see the brake pipe control needle in the center of your cab desk showing about 4 bar. That concludes this module. All the junctions in the training center are manual, so you can go anywhere you wish using the map and by changing junctions manually. If you want to practice, go to explore on foot in the training center. You'll find trains dotted around, and you can practice driving them and moving them around hard. Don't forget, you can always rerun this training module later if you can't remember any of what's been covered. In this training module, you will be taken through the operation of this Class 66 locomotive. During this brief introduction, you'll be covering the critical driving controls and freight operations. When you're ready, climb aboard to get started. You need to insert the reverser first, and then you can move it. Set the headlights to let others around us know this train is operational.
Set the headlights? You're running.
The direct brake has three positions: apply, hold, and release. They're directly affecting the brake cylinder pressure, shown on the left-hand side of the desk or on your HUD under the BC entry. While in the apply state, the brake cylinder or BC gauge will fill, meaning more and more brakes are being applied. Move the handle to the hold position to maintain the same level of braking, and back to the release position to reduce or completely release the brakes. The direct brake is used to apply the brakes only on your locomotive and are faster to apply and release than the main brakes. If you're only running as a light locomotive, as you are now, it's usually quicker to just use these brakes. Now, the brakes on this train require us to hold the brake handle in the release position. You can monitor the state of the brakes using the larger brake pipe control gauge in the center. Now keep the brake. Now that the brake pipe control is at 5 bar, the brakes will fully release. Watch the brake cylinder or BC gauge to see it gradually reduce to 0, which tells you that the brakes are now fully released and you can move the train. As you apply power, notice the amp bar rising. This is the amount of power being fed into the traction motors. But try to keep this out of the red, as it means you're overpowering the motors and could damage them. Built in London, Ontario, Canada by EMD, the British Rail Class 66 is a six-axle diesel-electric locomotive, used primarily for freight operations in the UK. Introduced in 1998, the initial order of 250 locomotives was said to be the biggest single order of a locomotive since the era of steam trains. More than 500 Class 66 locomotives were built, with the final one being delivered in 2016. The Class 66 has earned the nickname Shed because of its shed-like pitched roof.
Crank this baby up.
Okay, come to a stop using the direct brake now.
We need to get a little closer. We're gonna pass it.
The freight wagons are behind us. So change direction with the reverser, then change the junction indicated, either by walking over to it or using the map. The junction is correctly aligned, so you can now couple up to the freight. Approach slowly and stop just before the buffers. Don't forget to release the direct brake before you apply power.
I guess I could have I could have gotten in the back of the car.
You can couple and uncouple from either an external camera or on foot. So let's connect the formation using the external camera. Now, couple the locomotive to the freight wagons. Return to the first pair. Nice work! Change direction with the reverser and move the train forward into the indicated siding.
So I should have. Well, that... well I would have had.
Remember, You can couple and uncouple from either an external camera or on foot. So let's uncouple from the wagons on foot this time. That concludes this training module.
Thank you.